Okay, so thank you. My name is Justin Wack, otherwise known as CWack on Twitter, and I'm a blogger and a podcaster for Cool Blind Tech and Jailbreaking. So I'm here to talk to you today about something really important, and that something is accessibility. You know, it's so many people have disabilities, and at the end of the day, it's something that we should all consider, especially developers when making apps and tweets. So just a little bit about me first, however. So I have been using iOS since I was 4, and I've been jailbreaking since I was 5. I jailbroke my iPad 2 with Epson back in the day. Very nostalgic. So I was really surprised with what I could do with the phone or with the iPad. And that led me to, you know, want to take a more active stand in the community. So basically, the question I have for you is how. How does jailbreaking improve accessibility? How can, you know, people without disabilities improve on accessibility? Let's answer those questions right now. So jailbreaking provides a lot of options for people who are either, you know, visually impaired or totally or totally blind or hearing impaired. So before I go into that though, I'm going to give you a little demonstration of how I use my phone, because I use my phone a lot differently than most. So this is my iPhone 6 on iOS 8. So unfortunately, this is not jailbroken. Okay, so this is my iOS 6. Oh, okay, I'm sorry. Did I damage your drums? I'm sorry. Okay, so unfortunately, you guys won't be able to see my screen, but I want you to put yourself in my position for a second. Close your eyes and just imagine that you're using your phone when you're totally silent. So I'm going to show you a little bit about VoiceOver. So VoiceOver reads different elements on the screen. So I was flicking to the left. If I flick to the left, it moves to the previous element on the screen. And if I flick to the right, it moves to the next element. So I'm going to unlock my phone. So something interesting to note is that you hear sounds here. You hear a lot of different sounds reflecting different actions, which I will get into later. So I'm going to go, and I'm going to go to the JailbreakCon website. So I'm on Apple website right now. Yeah, I'm going to go to... I can type in Braille on my phone, which is awesome. So, and I'm on the Jailbreak phone website as soon as it was. There we go. So, you know, it's really great, and this extends system-wide. So this accessibility can be used on any application or even on Jailbreak tweets. I could even like do something if I was so inclined and it was really random. I could, you know, even do something like, I don't know, look up cows on Wikipedia or something like that. Oh, look at that. I'm going to click on this message and I'm going to read this message. So I'm going to click on this link. This is the YouTube one. Really? Really? Okay. At least it wasn't for Google. So then I can watch this YouTube video. Incidentally, this song is actually called Jailbreak. So now that I've shown you a little bit about how I use my phone, let's get into how jailbreaking helps me and other people. So, for people who have low vision, think about it. What's jailbreaking known for? What's one of the first things you do when you get your device? You put these on it. And for low vision people, since people obviously see things differently, literally and unfortunately figuratively, we have themes. So there's a theme for everyone, and it makes devices easier to understand. But there's also a lot of things that you can do if you are a blind jailbreaker, like myself. So I'm going to go to show you what I can do with VoiceOver that I've customized. So with VoiceOver, you can make custom sound schemes. So the actions you heard, like when it was making sounds to indicate that I performed actions, you can do custom sound schemes. So like this. Oh, thank you, Python. Okay. This device is still on iOS 7 and it doesn't like me very much apparently. Well, we're having some technical difficulties, but this is why I'm updating to iOS 9 in the fall, unless it's a joke. You can do custom sound schemes, but what you can also do is you can make custom voices. So this is great. I'm also hearing impaired. I wear hearing aids as well. So this is great for people like myself because I find certain voices easier to understand than others. And when I'm reading at 700 words per minute, I want to have a voice that I can understand. And I can actually understand voice over 700 words per minute. So essentially, you know, it's more choice. Same thing with hearing impairments. There's different tweaks that can contribute with hearing impairments, like haptic feedback tweaks, equalizer tweaks, even music tweaks to an extent if they help to improve the quality of the music. So the next question is, how can people with no disabilities help to improve upon accessibility? So I'm going to start with developers. Developing is obviously what makes one of the things that makes the iPhone go around. You have third-party applications everywhere. So in 2010, there was an American census that said 19% of the population had a disability. That's approximately 60 million people. In February of 2015, 47% of market share was dominated by iOS. So if you do the math, that equals to about 30 million Americans that have a disability. Now, by marketing your products as accessible, that makes it easier to sell to over 30 million Americans, let alone more than other people in the world. So, there's a couple things I want to mention. The first thing is, when you're developing a jailbreak tweak, there are certain things that just can't be made accessible. Unfortunately, VoiceOver doesn't do pretty pictures, so themes wouldn't work too well. Unless you found some genius way to describe a landscape or something, because usually it would be for that. The second thing is, so usually things that can be made accessible are things like settings panes tweaks, applications or standalone tweaks, and widgets. So Apple's documentation for accessibility is a great place to start if you're looking at making your applications accessible. And if your applications are already accessible, thank you, you are amazing. Additionally, there was actually a really good WWDC presentation this year that focused on accessibility. So something that I got out of that is that if you use Apple's APIs when developing your product, usually the application will turn out to be accessible. There's obviously certain things you're going to have to do in coding of the application itself, but it will usually be accessible. So the last thing I want to mention is media, because another big sector of this community is media, or even in the technology community. So media is extremely important. Accessibility needs to be viewed as something mainstream and cool, and it's not really as mainstream as it probably should be right now. So that's basically accessibility. But before I go, I do want to say a couple things. I just would like to thank everyone here and everyone I've interacted with over the past year from this community, because every single one of you have touched me in one way or another, and I am so blessed and honored to call myself a member of this community. The second thing I do want to say is this. If Jailbreak community has taught me one thing, it's to not consent to be average. Don't just, for example, if you want to do security research, don't just learn it, become great at it. set your mind to it, don't give up, and don't give in to stereotypes. And if you do that, you will never fail. So once again, my name is Justin Wack, and thank you guys so much for your time.